Hi guys, we are launching this series of videos in which we'll be talking about finance, marketing, operation, all those things. And today with us we have Dr. Pradeep. He is the Associate Dean Finance at VES College. So sir, today is a very informal way to ask you a question about finance, kya hai, kyun karna hai, kyun nahi karna. So I would like to start with my story. When I went to JBIMS, so JBIMS is famous for finance. और वहाँ जाते ही तो द मोमेंट द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ अकाउंट हैपन तो मैं समझा भाई अपने बस की बात नहीं है. बीइंग अ इंजीनियर, बीइंग अ पंजाबी, हमारे सामने बैलेंस शीट रखोगे हमें कुछ समझ नहीं आने वाला. सो देन आई क्विट फाइनेंस एंड मूव टूवर्ड अदर एरियाज. फाइन, सो वॉज इट द राइट डिसीजन? आई लेटर ऑन आई रियलाइज अ बैड डिसीजन. सो अकाउंट्स और फाइनेंस में कितना फ़र्क है?
हाँ, सो बेसिकली आईड लाइक टू क्लियर दिस, बिकॉज इन फाइनेंस इट्स नॉट ओनली अकाउंटिंग. Finance is basically club of two things. One is financing, that means sourcing of funds, and then application of funds. And finance, there is a world in finance which actually needs a lot of quantitative aptitude. So I'll suggest that if you're an engineer and you have got this quantitative aptitude and you want to have the feel of the world of finance, it is one of the good career.
Okay, great.
People are afraid of accounting, but accounting is just a small part
of
in that finance, because and then again you are not supposed to do the accounting part. You are supposed to actually handle the analytical part. Seeing a balance sheet, you need to understand the liquidity position of the company, solvency position of the company, how the working capitals are getting managed, how the sourcing is done, whether companies are at risk or not. So that we can, starting with seeing a balance sheet or PL account, we are trying to understand the performance of the company and also the asset liability situations. So that is the core of this accounting. But since you are doing a managerial, you need to know the basic things of that. So I think, to be very honest, this should be taken in the third semester, because I feel that pinch even in different colleges we have come across with the engineers.
Right.
They also have the same thing. But then later on, when you deal with the second semester or third semester, the actual specialization, wherein dealing with the risk analytics or dealing with the portfolio management, people get very interested. And also if you look at those colleges, IIMs and IITs, you will find a lot of engineers are taking finance as their career.
So that was my next question. Yeah. Because BCom wala finance karne ja raha makes sense. BMS jisne finance mein kiya makes sense. But being an engineer going for finance, there's always one question mark which everyone will ask. Mm-hmm. Even when you are doing your MBA, they'll ask you why finance.
Yeah.
Being an engineer, why finance? Even final also, why finance? Mm-hmm. So
to answer these questions, I'll just tell you that the business environment is changing and different models are coming and lot of technological innovations are taking place in finance, and you need to have some analytical skills where you need to have certain maths. Now if I talk about finance, one branch of finance, finance and economics, we call financial economics, or it can be econometrics, where or derivatives and risk management, again the portfolio optimization, these are the areas where you need lot of quantitative knowledge. So you should have the acumen both handling the programmings of these areas and develop certain models. So where I find that engineer can play a very important role.
Great. Sir, now coming back to the second point, a lot of people are doing the extra courses, CFA kar liya, ye kar liya.
Right.
So number one, is it required? Because tum ek jagah MBA finance already kar rahe ho, but do you think these will add values to my resume? And if yes, then which are the courses you think we can, as a student, I can do now that I'm preparing for MBA, I can do it now during the college or maybe end of the college? What is your take on that?
So I'll start with CFA. Basically, CFA is a course where lot of quantitative aspects are being taught. It's a difficult course. At the same point of time, you are dealing with lot of papers in semester 1, semester 2, semester 3. So idea will be that start CFA after completion of your third semester, or if you're at the fourth or fifth trimester. Why I'm saying, because then your main load on the PG is complete, you have an advanced knowledge, so you can handle it better, and your first chance you'll be able to clear the CFA.
Okay.
So that's the call. Again, If you are, when you are looking for a career in investment banking, you go for CFA as a career. If you are looking from perspective of the risk management or risk analytics as a career, then FRM could be a better option. Then also purely quantitative aspected course. But through this MBA, one thing that you can do, if you are continuing, I mean, suppose we get students who are doing inter, CA inter or CS inter, these kind of courses people are doing during their course. So they are already done something in their graduation, so that course can be continued. Right. So it's basically that. But to start a career in finance, then CA and CS is also a good aspect. CA actually trains you on the accounting, auditing and taxation side. So it is basically preparing you for the corporate finance role. Mm-hmm. Again, if I talk about CS, now companies which is having at least 5 crores as authorized share capital, they have to, so paid up share capital, they have to employ one CS. CS is basically taking on the legal part in the corporate affairs. Right. So these two are also a brilliant career.
Do you have MBAs who are doing CA afterwards?
Yes. We have students who are doing CAs, past CA inter kind of thing, and they're doing parallelly the final.
But sir, BCom ka link hoga.
So normally what happens, you start your career in CA after you pass your higher secondary.
Right.
So higher secondary and during BCom, you clear your inter and thus those compliance part like.
As an engineer, to nikalta engineers, I doubt ke koi somebody go.
No, engineers try, can do, but then normally we see that engineers preferring for these kind of courses, all quantitative courses like FRM, we can say this one CFA or MBA or PGDL.
NISM, maybe 2000 ka course obviously 2000 rupees per module is not a big amount.
See, NISM courses are basically short term courses that gave you the basic view of a particular segment. Suppose if I talk about capital market, now they have got a different segment. Capital market, they have course called SORM, Security Operation as Risk Management, course on mutual fund, course on derivatives. So these are different modules they have created. Now these, if you pass that particular course, they're basic in nature. They're not in detail course. So, I mean, those short term courses will help you to get a compliance, because if you start your career in capital market and you want to become a capital market dealer, then you need that certification. So that actually adds value to your career, value to your CV, that you have you are complied for the job. So that's why those short term courses. So even if you are doing the MBAs, you can do this, because only 2,200, even whatever is being taught to you, that will help you to clear those examinations. So those are the exams actually not for getting huge knowledge, but that is getting complied with the system. Now, if a broker wants to have a terminal, he need a person who is certified by NISM.
That's compulsory rule.
Then their certificate will be taken as a compliance and they will be allotted an ID. So getting an ID,
you have to give the exam.
You have to give the exam.
Great.
So even if you go to the corporate, you have to give the exam and sit for the exam. So why not during your course, you can have, and that course has got a three years, some courses has got 5 years of I think that is the compliance part for 5 years and validity.
Great. Sir, you also have a DABF course at your college, you're talking about that. So is it compulsory for everyone to sit for that?
What we have done, we have clubbed the DBF course, which is called Diploma in Banking and Finance, and this is given by the course is authorized by IIBF, Indian Institute of Banking and Finance. So the course is prepared in such a way by the IIBF, it is equivalent to CIIB, which a banker gives. And then if someone clears DBF, it adds value, and those who are looking at career in banking, they should clear this particular course. This course is also a heavy course, but what we have done in our PGDM courses, we have made it inbuilt. So the course structure is already been placed in the modules. Perfect. I mean in the different trimesters.
Great. Now talking about the placement point of view, what percentage of students go for banking and how many percent goes for a non-banking financial
job? Okay, now that depends on the, I mean, how they're looking at a job. Now, what we are seeing that the person
who is चाहता तो मैं बहुत कुछ हूँ लेकिन मिलने क्या वाला है तो
हाँ मिलने का क्या वाला है मैं आपको बताता हूँ सी नाउ बैंकिंग बोल के बैंकिंग इज नॉट अ फोकस्ड कोर बैंकिंग इन बैंकिंग हैव गॉट मल्टीपल प्रोडक्ट्स सो व्हेन आई एम लुकिंग गोइंग फॉर अ बैंक बैंक इज नॉट गोइंग टू पुट मी ओनली ऑन द बैंकिंग एज अ सर्विस सो देयर कुड बी डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट्स कुड बी वेल्थ मैनेजमेंट It can be wealth management where mm-hmm. bank can put you as a wealth manager. So you are selling the different products. Bank has got their mutual fund section. Bank has got their insurance sections because banks are not dealing only with the banking with the right now. Right. So it has got a variety of products. So if you have PGDM and also banking role, you can be placed at any point of time. In banking.
There was a time when banking the account khol was.
But it is not like that. Nowadays it is like you should be actually selling the different products that a banking has. So starting from the CASA to wealth management product and also the insurance and product. But if you're specifically looking for a career in risk management or a specific course on investment, a specific role on investment banker side, then probably PGDM along with CFA because after being PGDM you get an entry CFA will make your career faster
so okay now jobs point of view what you think is the top 2 or top 3 and top 3 jobs
see highly paid jobs are wealth management so if you join the wealth management team of a particular bank or particular program then it is basically a career that is always sought for apart from that you can find investment banking as a career and also core banking I mean different banking operation services so you can start with a manager banking operations or you can start a career in as a equity research analyst or equity advisor investment advisor kind of so these are the basic roles that after doing your MBA or PGDM that you can get
you can go for great so
even if you have CA inter passed so you can have a role in the accounting corporate finance also
so after my I hated finance the most I hated two areas finance and HR jo during my MBA always have the areas of preference so after my MBA when I started working the first project was HR project I was a consultant I worked as a consultant and 3 years out of 3 years of my career I worked for 3 years 2.5 years I was working for a bank the thing which I hated the most I have to work there the most even now when I start my own company even finance is required so being an entrepreneur also finance I use finance
See, I mean, finance we call lifeblood of the business. So, in case of when you are teaching with the, when you are dealing with finance, as an entrepreneur also, you need to have the acumen. Like raising funds, managing projects. So, okay, you can keep your employee who is expert in finance, but still, as an entrepreneur also, you need to know the basic things of finance. So, even in the curriculum of MBAs and PGDM, some basic courses are always taught to everyone. So, if you are taking even the marketing or operations, or then you need to have the basic knowledge of finance. So, like at least you need to understand what is liquidity, what is solvency, how to handle a project, how to evaluate a project, how to raise the finance for the organization. These are all the basic things that one needs.
Okay, so now I come to the main question. In every interview, they're going to ask me why finance. Engineering kya to kyun finance kyun kiya ye kyun kiya. So what you think is the ideal answer for that question? Now this is the other side. You normally ask the question to students. I'm asking this question.
See, normally what we have seen. I mean, for the last
21 year old, I have been aaya hu engineering khatam karke aaya hu. And I'm now going to sit for the interview, and I want to go into finance. And this is my answer at one of the top college which I gave at my time. I like maths, I like numbers, that's why I'm going to finance. उसके बाद उसने मेरी मारी है वहाँ पर इंटरव्यू में कि ये ज्ञान देता ये वो सो वॉट यू थिंक इज अ गुड आंसर
सी बेसिकली इट्स एवरीथिंग आई मीन वेन एवर वी आर टेकिंग अ सब्जेक्ट वी सी टू थिंग्स वेदर वी हैव द इंटरेस्ट इन दैट सब्जेक्ट वेदर वी हैव द एप्टीट्यूड नाउ इंटरेस्ट इज बेसिकली इंटरेस्ट विद द नंबर्स An aptitude whether you can deal with the numbers.
But sir, the answer they give is not.
No. Suppose they ask you. So the moment you say that I have a liking of the finance, obviously they are going to ask you some questions on finance. So then, what I feel that even in our organizations, in our I'm teaching for the last 6 years in this particular college, but we have seen a lot of engineers have taken finance, and they are most sought for when this kind of quantitative jobs are there. I mean, two or three of us even handling a big positions in JM Morgan, or we can say JM Morgan, Deloitte. So these are the companies that having a Nomura. These are the companies where they have a leading role playing in this. So it's not that engineers should not do a finance, but obviously you will be always have this question, why finance for an engineer? Because your object was different when you did the engineering. But since the trend is, what the trend talks about, that even the engineers are taking, they are playing a bigger role in developing the technology part on finance also. Like if I talk about artificial intelligence, machine learning, these are the new concepts that is being used in finance.
Okay.
So if you have engineering background, at least you are technically somehow equipped with these kind of things. Okay. Because we have seen that engineers are doing coding in R, coding in Python and all. So those are also used.
So we can link
finance.
It here. Yeah, okay, yeah. Great. So they have to be linked, first of all, to prove.
There is absolutely big link, as I have said, because quantitative part is big issue. And there are a lot of programming, a lot of analytical things are going on in finance. Like if I talk about the fintech, this is also used in finance nowadays.
Right.
So then the people are suited. And we have seen that engineers are most sought for when analytical finance are required. Mm. So because they have the background of coding. And normally, see, I don't say that people in the, people in the finance cannot do the coding. Coding can be done. But since they have got acumen and interest, they manage it better.
Great. So now if I have experience in finance, so obviously it's covered ho gaya ki because I worked there, I'm coming for finance. So if I don't have experience in that, if you have experience in coding or any kind of a thing, you can relate it to that.
Yeah.
Ki I want to get into this part of finance. I don't want to get into normal banking. I want to go into this part.
See, if I talk about that where you are developing a programming, I need some risk management software. Now, risk management software, you need to, before you create the algorithm, you need to know the basics.
Right.
Suppose I talk about option pricing formula. Formula, you should know. You should know the coding. So, functional domain knowledge as well as the working domain knowledge, coding working, together can make you a successful person. And company looks at that, company will not ask. पहले ऐसा होता था, consulting में गए तो एक functional से बैठे, एक जो expert है उस particular area में वो बैठे. Now people have got blend of these two things.
Right.
So I think that's the way, engineers are.
That can be folded.
And that's why you see, in different companies, IIM and all, people are taking, engineers are going and learning the finance.
True.
And as a career, it has got always importance. पैसा सबको चाहिए, पैसा सबको manage करना होता है, और इसलिए लोग पैसा पी भी करते. I know, people in finance, they're earning huge. Someone having MBA with CFA earning hefty amount.
Yes. MBA plus CFA, deadly combination. Even plus MBA plus CFA is also good combination.
Yes. MBA and CFA, MBA with FRM. They're in big positions. We have students holding big positions in the companies like Nomura, JP Morgan, Deloitte.
My one complaint with the finance people is that why that much jargon? Economics and kholo, most of the words I can't even, they won't say gold, they call it a bullion. They don't say share market, they call it equity. Itna jargon kyun? Let's keep it simple, marketing is simple. Marketing people keep it simple, they don't try to complicate. Finance people try to complicate things, like legal people they try to complicate things.
It's not basically creating complications.
I'm sorry, I'm just trying to joke around.
It's not basically creating complications. See, when I am a finance person, first and foremost quality that I should build is compliant, being a compliant. So being compliant means what? If I say that you have to call a spade a spade. So if I say what is share, then there is no other. In marketing, at least you can create your own version of saying something. Right, but finance specific hona padega.
Right, so that's why
share
can be anything, any kind of share.
Share can be anything, but if I say that talk about equity share, then equity share basically you have to tell what is an equity share is.
Perfect.
Aap usko ghuma phira ke bolne se nahi hoga. And normally, what we have seen that the legal terminologies that is being used in the finance, unless and until it is not written carefully, it will not be accepted in the court of law also. And then there could be a lot of disputes that come in, kind of finance domain. So that's why, basically we have to call a spade a spade, and then we have to be very compliant. Whatever we are saying, it should be, like if I say equity share, then you have to define what is equity share. If I say capital budgeting, then you have to say capital budgeting. But see, a lot of these kind of jargons are coming, like we talk about wealth manager and all this. But then all these are part of life. Finance, something which is integrated with the everyday's life. Working capital. आज एक organization चलाना है आपको सुबह से ये तो पता होना चाहिए कि fund कहाँ से आएगा.
True.
आज मुझे एक payment करना है तो मुझे पता होना चाहिए ना. और मान लो मेरे पास 130 करोड़ रुपये आज पड़ा है, शनिवार पड़ा है, सोमवार यूज़ करना है, तो संडे क्या करूँ पैसे का?
You invest in that.
You invest in liquid fund. Finance has every answer to. So you ask, we are there to answer.
To help that. Great. So now you answer my all the questions. Now if I do any course, now I am preparing for MBA. For example, those who are going for their MBA, they've not yet joined a college. They are just taken a gap year. So if they do any kind of a course, like there are a lot of courses available for short-term course, long-term course, NASM ho gaya. So do you think if I do a course, will that add into the resume for interviews?
Suppose I am doing the graduation level. Now, graduation level, I can do these NISM courses, short-term courses.
But will you like them in an interview?
Obviously, why not? Why not? When we are taking interview, we try to understand two things. One, three things. One is social awareness. What is his additional thing that he has done apart from graduation, and whether he has got a work experience or kind of thing. These are the three parameters that every colleges are looking at. So if you are doing additional courses, that gives an added advantage in the selection process. That's for sure.
Great.
Suppose I get a student who has done three modules cleared, because those modules doesn't say that you have to be MBA to clear those modules, and those modules are, that shows interest. So basically we look at whether the candidate has got the interest in that particular domain or not.
So and if I don't do from NISM, if I do any chota mota course which is available,
even if you're doing some courses on marketing, or even do some courses on tally. So tally is an accounting
package.
So that always enhance value in your bio data.
Great. Kuch bhi karo, matlab karo,
kuch bhi karo, because graduation के समय पे आपके पास जो भी स्पेयर टाइम मिलता है, यू शुड ऑलवेज कीप ऑन लर्निंग. इवन नाउडेज यू हैव द डिफरेंट कोर्सेस रन थ्रू कोर्सेरा, द ऑल ऑफ फ्री कोर्सेस. सो यू कैन डू गेट अ सर्टिफिकेट, 1500 यू गेट अ सर्टिफिकेट, यू गेट द डिजिटल सर्टिफिकेशन, डिजिटल लर्निंग. सो दैट प्रिपेयर्स यू बेटर इन द क्लास.
ग्रेट.
सो द फ्रॉम फर्स्ट डे you'll be in a better position. Suppose you are talking about financial accounting. Suppose you have done the graduation and financial accounting. This between these particular point, you can have some Coursera courses on financial accounting.
Superb.
Free digital learning. You can
so
do
this
it.
Is now the target for all the people who are here.
Yeah, I'll
you
advise
should do one course.
Yes,
push
yes.
me a course, a yes, Kerlo yes. course.
Yes.
And you'll understand everything.
At least 3 years you can do three courses. And those who can spend more time on studies, so they can do even in one course in each semester.
Yes, during MBA also.
During MBA also, there are advanced courses. During MBA, you learn R, you learn Python. Though we are teaching, but then you can learn R and Python before you join an MBA course.
Superb. Thank you, sir. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
It's a wonderful experience.
Thank you.